Next we have Pecha Kucha. That sounds Japanese, I guess. What do you think, Sandhya? Let me hear it from Ms. Nirupama, HOD, IHM, Sri Shakti, Hyderabad, VP, L&T, Telangana. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Bindu. Pecha Kucha, telling stories with pictures. Pecha Kucha was created in Japan in 2003 by renowned architects Astrid Klein and Mark Dytham. In Japanese, basically chit-chatting is called Pecha Kucha. Pecha Kucha is a storytelling format in which a presenter shows 20 slides for 20 seconds each. Individuals gather at a venue to share personal presentations about their work. It's a unique presentation style where these presentations are known to be used for creative disciplines to share their work or a journey or a story. Let us hear some of such type of work from our life members. And to start with, we have Ms. Arpita Singh. Arpita Singh is an educator mentor with over 22 years of teaching experiences and 5 years of industry experience in the rooms division department. Belonging to the city of joy, Kolkata, she has done her graduation in hospitality from AH and MA in the year 1998 and master's in tourism management. She has been a registered trainer mentor for a few universities of United Kingdom. Presently, she works with the International Institute of Hotel Management, Kolkata, as an HOD, Accommodation Operation Department. She has been an active member of Young Chef Olympiad for the last 10 years, attended many seminars as guest speakers for both online and offline sessions on sustainability and other trends. She is currently undergoing her PhD in hospitality from Macau under West Bengal University. A good round of applause for Arpita Singh.
Thank you so much. Am I audible now? Okay. AV team requesting you to play the PPT once I finish the intro. Okay. So what should I say? Good evening. I prepared my speech as good afternoon. Anyway, hope you all enjoy my 20 seconds slides, which is a little difficult because we are used to, as an educator, we are used to talk so much. Okay, and thank you all of them in the back of the house. I'm seeing them working for a long time. Thank you all my seniors, my colleagues, my juniors, my students over here. To start, can I just request the AV team to go back again, because the slides will, you go to the, don't go to the slideshow. Yes. Okay. So give me, fine. So as you can see, you have to go back, please. Okay. So my topic for today is, as you can see, is ergonomic matters. I will be presenting on this topic today, which is related to environmental health and safety. So we have talked about sustainability, we have talked about AI. My topic today will be on environmental health safety. So we can start. The AV team, you can now do the slideshow. Yeah. So with the introduction where I've written, the protecting the health of housekeepers is should be our prime responsibility. According to the Occupational Safety and Health Association, which was established back in 2001, 33% of our workers face injuries due to bad ergonomics. So to continue, ergonomics has been derived from the Greek word organ, which means work, and nomoi means natural laws. So it is a study, basically a science of working with artificial intelligence equipments so that our workers, they are less harmed when they are doing their work on a regular basis. So to continue, the next slide. As per the famous J.W. Marriott says that take care of the employees and the happy employees will take care of their guest. Yes, employees are our internal guest, and not taking much of time, I will say that if we keep our employees' health in safeguard, we will be able to cost control, turnover of the companies, which is very high nowadays. People don't stick to hospitality industry because of more of prolonged hours of working and lot of laborious jobs, especially in housekeeping, which is a tireless and thankless job. To continue, I would like to say some principles which has been laid down by the ISO, established in 2004. We should be able to adopt healthy work procedures, proper body postures to be used for heavy lifting, and it goes for us who all are, maximum of us are above 40, 30s, even youngsters are there, but we should always, when we are heavy lifting, we should be in the squat position rather than deadlift. You all are going to gym, so you all can relate to it. So more of the principles, which I will just continue, is avoid standing long hours. Wherever possible, give rest to your employees, especially in the laborious team. Work and motion study, which is a very important thing, which we take up with our students. Work and motion study, where it says how 8 hours of shift we can utilize our employees, but not harming their well-being. Some to mention some principles more: adjustable and comfortable chairs, arms and backrest. Legs are to be more used, in the sense if you are using laundry machine, we use more on the foot paddles than on the hand. So similarly, you'd rather than to pull items, we should teach our employees to push wherever is required. To continue, the benefits of ergonomics, why we are going for an ergonomical thing. All around us, both in our home, at our home also, we should follow this. We should not lift things like and be a dead man. Sorry, I just want to break the monotony. Improves work quality, reduces work pain, and a good health for your employees will give you a healthy, happy working environment. This is what we teach to our students all over. To carry on, there are some trauma injuries that can take place. I'll go quickly. That happens due to forceful exertion. We are due to lifting of heavy objects, bending, twisting, where a small example, while bathtub cleaning, we advise generally to go inside, put a mat, and then clean the bathtub. So that is what I wanted to explain here. Some housekeeping tasks that can be very laborious is using the hand armrest again and again. So we teach them in one motion, circular, anti-clockwise, clockwise, but we don't teach them that change your posture and do the cleaning procedure. So in the modern equipments, that is what is AI teaching us, to give us better equipment so that our ergonomical factors are strong. If I'm not wrong, many of them have said this in their presentation, how comfortable mattresses they're giving, how comfortable cleaning cards they're giving. So both from the internal and external guest perspective. Okay, some of the tasks which generally can cause pain for the housekeepers more are scrubbing, cleaning, dusting, high to reach areas where we are using those telescopic handles. And the many pioneer companies have come, many of them have showcased today only. And we have something called Yungar, which is doing great. I think internationally, like Diverse, they are also accepted. So the risk factors which happens, what happens if you have bad ergonomics? If you have bad ergonomics, you have bad health for the worker. So this is what happens. The forceful exertion when you are lifting heavy mattresses day in and out, we all have workers, or we all have worked someday with such things. Then awkward positions, repetitive activities, similar work postures for long periods, like in calendaring machine, you go on feeding the bed sheets and then you never know when the 8-hour shifts end. No muscle rest while working causes us the WMSDS, that is the musculoskeletal disorder, which we say. And for that, above 40, most of us have the knee pain and the sciatica. That's a very bad disease. You can change the AV team, yes. To make the work easier, we teach our students that use fitted sheets, don't use those throwover. So we, instead of those traditional throwovers, we use the fitted sheets. Supply cards are to be a level on between your chest and waist so that it is easier. Force is not exerted so much. Vacuum cleaners, I know most of them, Diversey, Tusky, all of them are talking about the AI and motorized carts and vacuum cleaners and all this. So both of, all of them have ergonomical factors nowadays. For washroom, we are using long handles and moreover with a lot of sponge or those fiber grips, which are not waterproof. Then we have the telescopic cleaning, glass cleaning, the scrubbers, which are used so that we don't have to see much on the neck side, because when you are pushing this, you develop spondylitis. For dusting, definitely we have the Pioneer. See, they have given the stall also. They have come out with lot of microfiber products and extendable handles. I can see all the stalls have ergonomical cleaning supplies, amenities, and equipments. And you can change the slide. Yes, please. The work system which makes easier is what harms ergonomics is number of beds in the room, and now we are putting so many supplies in the room. Just think of the poor housekeeper. How many times they have to go to the cart, take the supplies and amenities, but we have to do our work. There is no other way. So we have to teach them how we can do our work in system with the work system and not harming themselves. I think it makes sense, and I'm trying my best to explain this. And definitely the employee condition nowadays, we are many physically able, disabled people which we are recruiting in our companies. We are recruiting many women power. So on this, we would like to say, I would like to say that please check the physical condition, and then if possible, the management should allot the work. And then the tools and equipments I've already talked about. Some simple task what we do is, nowadays to make simple is those walk-in showers versus the tub cleaning. So when there is walk-in shower, you don't have to really bend down and do a lot of exertion. So walk-in showers, as you can see, to save water, all this, the tubs are being discarded and walk-in showers are coming in. Though I did not see any display over here yet, but yes, it's there in our places like hometown, etc. You get them in those street fairs. What is the need of ergonomics, if you can change? Yes, a successful work system will only work if the management must be committed towards their employees. Supervisors must empower their employees to give ideas. It should not be a directive. It should be a very much as the leadership qualities was explained sometimes back. It should be a consultative workplace, not a directive. When it is upward and downward direction, it is always a dictatorship where ideas are not welcomed. So employees will not open up to you and they will not say their problem to you. So supervisor must empower their employees to give their views and tell their problems, which a few decades ago was a problem. Employees must understand basic risk, for which our training department, I'm sure, they are giving training session, they are giving yoga session. We as a part of academics, we do so many things on this. We train our students, we send them outside, we train them to be for having a healthy life, healthy food, healthy workouts, like we teach our workers, no, that from morning shift, before you come, you do some warm-up exercises. So employees must understand the risk of taking the laborious job. Please change the slides. I think it should automatically come. Every team. Yes. Considering I've already seen that it has been discussed, so I will not go much. Team cleaning, it was discussed here a few minutes back, that it reduces isolated work. A person, when it is, there are several methods of cleaning, like a block cleaning method. So nowadays, what we do is a team cleaning method to save the labor cost also, and also to avoid isolated work areas for our employees. It can help in all way for keeping a good housekeeping. Housekeeper safety should be our first and foremost thing. Like we say, Atithi Deva Bhava, even our employees are our internal customers. So they are also should be treated and placed equally, so that in turn they give us in return. So the housekeepers should be taught all this, what is shown in the slide, and the need of what is, I can see the need of ergonomics, why it arised. Because they are performing, you know, I'll give you a fact that a room attendant, a GRA, turns 3 seconds every time. So 8,000, approximately 8,000 body posture in 8 hours of shift. And this is a study, work and motion study has taken out. So if you refer the American Hotel and Motel Association, all these books for housekeeping, you'll see they have been approved all this. So these are the analysis that for long working hours, we should take care of our employees, and to avoid the risk factor, we should be asking all the questions which were shown, and to move the work to a comfortable height so that it gives relaxation to the worker. Now to conclude, I'll come to the conclusion, where with this I would not take much of time, as I was showing, what I show in classes, I put students there, so I could have shown you the lifting techniques. We don't do deadlift. We generally do squat. We don't do deadlift. We do squat for heavy lifting. We don't take things all together. We use the carts. Carts are to be motorized with caster wheels and so many things on and on. I will not take much of your time now. To conclude, I will say that with this, I would like to conclude my slides and should ask or encourage managements to take up ergonomics as a very serious matter, otherwise which can be very challenging, and we will have a tough time to find staff in near future. Thanking you, I think I have finished my presentation. These are the references which I got. If anybody has any question, they can put forward to me. And should I say goodnight also? I don't know. But anybody after me, I also don't know. I will hand over to Ms. Nirupama. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Arpita.
Arpita, please stay. Please stay.
May I request Ms. Viji Raman, Regional Housekeeper, Apollo Hospitals, to come on stage and facilitate Ms. Arpita.
B-H-A, 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 B-H-A.